Thanks for joining us this morning. There's fresh damning evidence over the response by Texas police to the Uvalde school shooting.
It's been revealed officers had enough armed officers on the scene to stop the gunman after he entered the building.
The officers had weapons. The children had none. The officers had body armor. The children had none. The officers had training. The subject had none.
It's full on, isn't it? Live US correspondent Alison Petrowski, who is following this special hearing. Ali, they are calling this an abject failure.
Yeah, it really is, guys. Good morning to you both. The hearing told this morning that Texas police officers could have stopped the shooting within 3 minutes. At that point in time, they had seven armed police officers on the scene. Instead, we're seeing new surveillance images of police with rifles and also with ballistic shields who waited for nearly an hour in the hallway outside the classroom where the gunman was inside. What is even more disturbing, Ali and Carl, is that there is preliminary evidence from some of this footage which suggests that no police officer even tried to open the door, that they assumed that the door was locked and they were waiting for a key. This is the Texas Public Safety Director, Steve McCraw.
And while they waited, the on-scene commander waited for a radio and rifles. Then he waited for shields. Then he waited for SWAT. Lastly, he waited for a key that was never needed.
Steve McCraw, absolutely scathing in his assessment of the school police chief, Pete Arredondo. Arredondo was not at the hearing, but McCraw said that Arredondo put the lives of his officers in front of the lives of the children, 19 students and two teachers killed in the massacre, and their grieving families holding a meeting last night. And not surprisingly, Ali and Carl calling for Arredondo to resign.
Grieving and angry. Ali, thank you.